Get ready to match the stars. Jimmy Walker, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Lee Merriweather, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dulafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Roeder.
And friends, I've always wanted to do that. Do that again. Get me a taxi, would you? You can do that too. Don't, it hurts
a
microphone.
Do I have a boy for you? What an attractive outfit that is, Bruce.
Are you poking fun at me?
No, I love
that. Best dressed
jacket.
Person on this stage, you're making a snide remark about my wardrobe.
I love it.
You're just gonna stand there and kid about it?
Listen, that is very sweet.
You ever
seen
that. Anything as beautiful as this in your whole life? Save my money, I'm going to get the jacket to go with me. What's that?
I like that.
Yeah, thank you very much. All right, here is our current champion, Don Sylifant, who has $5,800 to his credit. Yeah. Now, as we finished last time, you won your third game, and that added $100 to it, and now you're going to try for over $5,000 for the third time. You've hit once and you've missed once, and we'll see how this one ends up. You ready for it?
I'm ready.
Okay, we'll spin that. Big thing goes round and round a moment or so, but right now this. All right, here we are with Don Sylifant, his third shot at the Big Apple. Shall we have a go at it?
Let's get it.
Okay, let's try for it. We polled a recent studio audience, Don. We got their best response to this. The naked blank. Remember, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if they matched you, or if you matched them. The next one, $250, and the third, $100. Three of the celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you choose?
I'm going to try Gary this time.
Gary.
Bestseller, The Naked Ape.
The Naked Ape, he says. All right.
Brett.
Brett, what do you say?
Oh, I have two, and I can't decide. I think I'm going to go with The Naked and the Dead.
The Naked and the Dead. Another big book and a big motion picture, too.
Richard.
The Naked Runner. It's a street crew passed me on Hollywood Boulevard. A book and a movie, The Naked Runner.
I told you to stay off of Hollywood Boulevard, didn't I?
I was looking for you, Gene.
Oh, I see. All right. So you got The Naked and the Dead, The Naked Ape, and The Naked Runner. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Don.
I think I'll stick with Gary, The Naked Ape.
The Naked Ape is the one he's going to choose. All right, Gary's got his fingers crossed. We'll find out if it's up there, and if it's there, where is it? But we'll begin down at the bottom by revealing the $100 response. The Naked Truth.
Oh, we're was that off on one of those again.
We is haven't that heard that for so long, we forgot
yes.
it.
Yes, that's right.
They forget quickly, don't they? Okay, looking for The Naked Ape, here is the $250 response. The Naked City.
That was my second choice.
Gosh, this is strange. The last two times we've been up here.
Yesterday they didn't remember Frederick March.
Yeah, now.
I remember a television series from 20 years ago.
There's the last chance for The Naked Ape. Here's the $500 response. The Naked Ape, you got it. So, Don, that puts you over $6,000. Now you've got $6,300. You're going to try for an even $5,000 now. Remember to collect. You have to match one of them head-to-head. It has to be an exact match. It's time to choose one now.
I'm going to stick with Naked Gary.
You're going to stick with Naked Gary. All right, you face me. And if you're ready, Naked Gary, here is the $5,000 question. Lightning blank. Lightning blank. Lightning blank. All right, Gary's finished. Now, Don, your response, please, that you think will match Gary. How do you fill in that blank? Lightning
bolt.
Lightning bolt. Most of them think you're right. We'll find out right now if you match Gary by asking him to reveal his answer. For $5,000, may we see it?
I was doing so well, too. I won last week $5,000 for a girl. I'm so... Oh, my goodness, I did say...
He's got $11,300. He says he loves it. Now, what are you going to do with all that money again?
I'm just going to have to think about it for a while.
You are. All right.
He's going to go to a motel. He's so exhausted.
His wife is sitting out there, and she's very happy about it. There she is. And we congratulate you. And now let's bring on another player, shall we, Don? And welcome Dee McCartan. I said, you know Don D. How's Dee McCartan?
Fine, thank you.
Good. Would you please tell us who she is?
Well, she's married, and she lives in Huntington Beach. We have two children, a daughter, Laura, and a son, Gary. And I love playing tennis.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
It's a good game. All right. You ready to play this game?
Oh, I sure am.
You ever play this game at home?
All the time.
You do? Mm-hmm. Good. Well, let's see how good you are. Ask
Hope
you to make
shows.
A selection, Dee.
B, please.
B? Everybody plays?
Why don't we go to our home and play?
Yes, we could play right in our house, couldn't we?
She
bring the cameras
cute.
In, they wouldn't take up much room. Now, you've all seen Yul Gibbons' latest commercial. You know the one I mean, where he travels America visiting family reunions? Have you seen that one?
Okay. Yes!
Well, Yul Gibbons said, he said, last week, I went to the Godfather's family reunion. I served him a huge bowl of grape nuts and got the surprise of my life. The Godfather put blank in it.
Oh, I've got it!
Served the Godfather, huge bowl of grape nuts, got the surprise of his life because the Godfather put blank in it. All right, did you hear all that, Dee? All right. And you know, you've seen Yul Gibbons.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Everybody ready. Now we go over here to Dee McCartan. You know the commercial I'm talking about where Yul Gibbons travels all over America. And he said, last week I went to the Godfather's family reunion. I served him a huge bowl of grape nuts and got the surprise of my life. The Godfather put blank in it.
Wine.
Wine. Good answer, I think. I think that's good. The Godfather might put wine in grapefruit. I wouldn't. You wouldn't. In grape nuts, rather. Would you put wine in grape nuts? Would you?
No, not the Godfather.
No?
Since there is a sugar shortage... Gunpowder.
Gunpowder. Okay.
Mistaken for brown sugar.
No wine yet, but let's see if it comes up here with Brett's answer.
Oh, honey, I was sure I had a winner this time.
Really?
I said spaghetti sauce.
Spaghetti sauce, another good answer. Yep, very good. Spaghetti sauce would have been a good choice. Gary?
Jimmy and I were on the same wavelength. I was going for sugar, and there were some Italians in my family, you know. We put Parmesan cheese.
Parmigiano. All right. So yeah, I got cheese and gunpowder, and we got all kinds of goofy stuff here. What are you going to put in the grape nuts?
Well, the most horrendous part of the movie, the first part one... was that scene with the horse? And I said horse meat.
Horse meat.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
It was cut out of the TV version.
I didn't know you thought that.
Tape her mouth.
Remember the invitation I had for the, you know, to attend the children's concert? I'm withdrawing it. I said spaghetti sauce.
Spaghetti sauce is good, yeah. All right.
I know a joke.
No. Vino?
No, I said he put bullets in it.
He put bullets in the grape nuts. Okay. So there's no match for you there, Dee. If you had said spaghetti sauce, you would have done very well with your first round question. But you didn't, and we'll get to your first round question in a moment or so. But right now, we've got to get to this. Here it is. All right, here we are. Going to finish round one. Don, ready for this? Listen carefully. It's all yours. I have an important announcement. The Match Game 75 Award for Outstanding Achievement goes to Brett Summers, the face that blanked 1,000 TV sets. The face that blanked 1,000 TV sets.
I would care to hear that question one more time, my darling.
The Match Game 75 Award for Outstanding Achievement goes to Brett Summers, the face that blanked 1,000 TV sets.
You got it.
All right. Jimmy and Gary. Gary's finished. We're waiting for Jimmy.
All right, Jimmy. Remember what good friends we are. Remember how kind I've been to you in the lean days.
In the lean days.
All right.
But he's fat now? What?
We'll come over here to Don Silifan. The important announcement, Match Game 75 award for outstanding achievement goes to Brett Summers, the face that blanked 1,000 TV sets.
Watch it! Yeah.
All I can think of is stopped or turned off.
Turned off?
Turned off 1,000 TV sets.
They're mumbling. You don't like it, though. All together. Well, I don't know if that's going to happen over here, whether you're going to score with that or not.
That's it.
Is that it?
That's it. That's no good. Well, we'll leave.
No. What did you say, Jim?
It was a tough question. It's a tough answer. It's a tough world.
Tough.
Broke.
Broke. All right, what did you say, my dear?
You don't think I'd sell my soul for a cheap joke, do you?
No. Heck no.
I said lit up.
To lit up a thou had a girl. Be proud.
To break 1,000 TV sets.
Yeah. Gary?
Do you think that she would sell her soul for a cheap joke?
No.
No.
But you would.
She'd give it away. Broke.
Broke, all right. Seth broke twice and lit up once. Lee?
As in the old mirror. Cracked.
Cracked 1,000 TV sets.
Well, from an old Miss America, what do you expect?
No, listen, she's not that old. She was Miss America 1912 or something like that. Yes, Richard?
I'm surprised the panel and Don would turn on this darling lady.
Yes.
She's a very popular lady throughout the country.
And she's very big on this show.
And she's responsible for the selling of a lot of TV sets. I sold mine, and then...
I hate you, Dave.
Face that sold 1,000 TV sets. Okay.
I think it's terrible the way it's going. Everybody talking like that, but it's true.
And broke 1,000, just broke would have worked. Well, we got another one of them pitcher's duels going here. Zip to zip is the score. I don't want to say we got two dummies up here because I can't say that because he's already won $11,300. Let's see how we go with round two, D.
B, please.
B it is. Everybody plays again. The lady said to the bald man, I don't care if you are Alan Funt. Get your candid camera out of my blank. That's what she said.
I don't care if you are Alan Funt.
Get your candid camera out of my blank. Immediately.
You can't say Dennis Jay.
Love you when you're angry.
Have you finished? Are you just fooling around here?
Finished.
This is a very serious show.
I know. Get your camera out of my...
I don't care if you are Alan Funt. Get your candid camera out of my blank.
Jean?
Yes?
She may be lousy on the screen, but she's great on the telephone.
What does that mean?
She means you're a good
talker. Always calls at 3 o'clock in the morning in a soft voice, so...
D. McCartan now. At bat, the lady said to the bald man, I don't care if you are Alan Funt. Get your candid camera out of my blank.
The only thing I can think of is bedroom.
Bedroom. Get your candid camera out of my bedroom. She says, get your camera out of my bedroom, Jimmy.
No.
No? What?
Lavatory.
Bathroom. Okay.
Of course.
All right. That narrows it down, Brett.
I was in the tub at the time.
You were.
And I said, get your candid camera out of my bathroom.
That's two of those, Dee. Let's see what Gary comes up with.
Were your goldfish blindfolded? Several weeks ago, I figured they might have. I said bathtub.
Bathtub. Three so far in that room. Now, Lee.
Gary, what were you doing in there?
Yeah. Four. Wow. Richard, do you make it five?
It would have been a good thing for you to say. Yeah, I said shower.
Shower, bathtub, bathroom. Well, I guess all of those were about the same. Joyce, do you make it unanimous?
Yeah, I think I do. I said he was in my pie looking for my secret recipe. Better than something else, I could have
said. Are you cracking up in your old age? I don't care if you are Alan Funt. Get your candid camera out of my pie.
What do you call it?
While we're straightening out the weirdo here, we'll have a little message for you. I gotta talk to you. All right, here we go with the second half of round two. You're in a good spot again, Don. All you need is one to win your fourth game. The psychiatrist said, I have a patient who keeps running off to Australia. His family retrieves him, and he goes right back. He thinks he's a blank. I have a patient who keeps running off to Australia. His family retrieves him, and he goes right back. He thinks he's a blank. He's not really. He just thinks he's one. You got it. Right off the bat.
What is he really? He's a psychotic is what he is.
All right.
I saw Paul Lynn last night.
Joyce, put it in the slot. Okay, here we go. Now, Don, psychiatrist said, I have a patient who keeps running off to Australia. His family retrieves him, and he goes right back. He thinks he's a...
It's got to be a boomerang.
A boomerang. One boomerang.
What is wrong with all of us today?
Native to Australia wins a game. Jimmy?
Well, Australia is not a strong area for my people. So I don't know too much about it. So I said kangaroo.
A kangaroo.
Of course.
All right. He thinks he's a kangaroo. He keeps wanting to go back to his native land. Brett?
Do you have the feeling we're all meeting like this?
Yes.
I said kangaroo.
Yeah, well, a kangaroo would have been a good answer if he had said it, but it's a boomerang is a better one. Gary?
I hate Qantas. Don, I'm sorry, I said kangaroo, too.
Three kangaroos. All you need is one boomerang and you've won another game, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen, Lee.
I almost said koala bear, but I said boomerang.
Boomerang wins the game. All right. We have two boomerangs there. Congratulations, Don. Now, Dee, we've got to part company with you. It was a pleasure to meet you. Thank you very much, Dee McCartney. A gift for you backstage. Dee McCartney, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, this fellow now is up to $11,400, right?
Still climbing.
Still climbing. Let's see how much higher you are going to climb as we point out to you that we polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Blank England. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 and $250 and $100. You know how that goes. Three of these people, remember, are permitted to help.
I'll take Sir Richard.
Sir Richard, what do you say?
We always call it Merry Old England.
Merry Old England. Yeah. All right, there's one for you.
I'll take Gary.
Well, we always called it New England.
New England. All right.
Joyce,
what do you say?
London, England.
London, England. All right, so it's London, England, Merry Old England, and New England. What say you to that?
New England.
New England. You're letting that audience sway you, aren't you?
No.
I
already had my mind made up, but I just wanted to see what they had to offer.
Even before they started applauding for New England, you thought you were going to say that.
Well, I knew I was going to select that before I asked them. I was just curious to see if they could get it too.
Saved us a lot of time.
What'd you make me go through all that for?
It's no fun for us, you know.
Yes, Don. Right. This is hard work, John.
Since you've had money, you became unbearable.
That's right.
Just wait till your house is on fire.
For? He used to be grateful to
us. Unassuming fireman doing his duty. Now he's rich and... Stand over there, Don, while I... All right, now let's begin and look as we look for New England by revealing the $100 response. Merry Old England.
That's about what it's worth at the moment.
That's right.
Just get London out of the way.
Here we go with the $250 response. Oh. New England, you've got it. Congratulations. That's the one Gary Berghoff gave you. Okay. What do you think is under the $500?
London.
That's who gave you that? Joyce gave you that one. All right. You think they'll always be in England? Well, I'm sure of that.
I don't think so, but
in spite of the inflation. But let's see if London, England is under the $500 response. Yes, it is indeed. You're right, audience. Well, you know, you fooled me, audience. You all say London, but when he said New England, you all applauded as if you thought that would be the best one up there. You're
That's
a sneaky
hedging.
Bunch.
Hedging yeah. your bets.
Hedging your bet is right. Okay, you got $250. You play for $2,500 now. And remember, you've got to match one of them head-to-head. Has to be exact match. Which one will it be?
Gary.
Okay, Gary, you get ready to write. Here's the $2,500 question. Big blank. B-I-G blank. Big blank. He's finished. Okay. Now, we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his. Big.
Well, as long as we're in England, I'm going to say Big Ben.
Big Ben. All right, Gary, he says Big Ben will match you. Does he collect the 2,500? Show and tell time. Go.
What I want to know is, do I get 10%?
Big Ben. And for you, this message. Terrific! Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time, and goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.